I'm Judith Monroe, and this is my studio. In this video, I'm gonna show you how to make something kind of like this. It's a form of camera obscura out of a plain cardboard box. Before I tell you too much more about that, I wanna explain, this is a really wonderful tool because it's got a little place where I can put a piece of tracing paper, and it's got a focusable lens, a lens that I can focus the image with, and a little screen so that I can kind of see the image a little bit better. This is a camera without any kind of real light sensitive material to record the image with, like way back when, before film. I am definitely going to make something very similar, less sophisticated, with this cardboard box. So I'm gonna start by showing you this camera Lucida a little bit better. It is a very nicely made wooden box. It was given to me by someone who knows I teach photography. And I just want to show you, this is the setup. If you look down here, you can see the lens, but it's projected onto a clear glass. Maybe this is plexiglass. And so it's really hard to see the image until I put something that diffuses the light. And I'm just going to move the lens a little bit and try to focus it. You can see the items in my mirror, my window. Again, see if we can, oh, there, they start to come into focus. And it looks a lot just like a silhouette here. I'm gonna put it in my window. So I've moved over here to my window, looking out across my neighbor's house. And I'm gonna move that lens a little bit again. And you can see that as I move that lens, it brings the image into focus. And you can see my neighbor's house across the street. Pretty cool. This is how it's sitting in the window. And when I'm done with my camera obscura, this is gonna be the easiest way for me to record the image. We'll see if I can get another image of my neighbor's house. Here on my work table, I'm collecting the things I'm going to need. I'm starting with a cardboard box, and because this design is gonna be a little different than the Camera Lucida, I need something that's gonna fit inside the box and create the focus. I'm still gonna need to be able to focus that image, and so I have another cardboard box that I'm gonna use to create this frame inside. The other thing I'm gonna need is a lens. And so my husband just had a Diet Coke. And I'm gonna create a pinhole, a metal pinhole lens. Sometimes if you have a small magnifying glass, you can use that, but I didn't have that. And I know that a little pinhole will also focus light. So no shortage of soda cans. And so to help with that, I also have a pair of metal cutting scissors, my handy box cutter, which I'll need for the cardboard and probably the can, a push pin. This is what I'm gonna use to make my pinhole with. Black duct tape. My friend, to help me make things light tight. And then I also have, I've got some tracing paper, some vellum. I need something transparent, but that's not completely clear. So like that Camera Lucida doesn't work with plain glass. It's gotta have tracing paper on it. I know you can also use wax paper or parchment paper, things you have in the kitchen. So the first thing I'm going to do is cut a square out of this can. You could also poke a hole in the bottom of it, but I feel like this is the easiest way. Be careful. Now I have my little square of metal. It's got sharp edges. It doesn't have to be perfectly square. I'm gonna try to make it flat, and I'm going to poke a hole through it. I'm going to try a hole that's the width of this whole push pin. So I'm just using this cardboard as a backing because it helps to get it to go all the way through. So I pushed it all the way through, and now I've got this nice little pinhole. The next thing I want to do is mount that pinhole on the end of my box. And I've got these extra flaps in here, which I feel like are going to cause me some trouble. So I think I'm going to trim those back. And I need to make a hole in the middle here and then try to make it light tight. Again, be careful. So I have sealed up all of the places where light could get in here. I could look at this out my window or just stick my head in it, but that's not gonna work really here. But I can see that there's no light coming in through here, and that's the big thing. So I'm gonna use this because I save boxes. But I want to create a frame that I can hold a piece of paper on that fits pretty snugly inside this box and can slide back and forth. So that's gonna require me to fold this box a little differently. Hopefully I can make it work without too much of a challenge. Okay, so now I have my very rough Camera Obscura, but I have a couple of crucial elements. I have a lens. This is a very simple pinhole lens, and I have a viewing screen that I can move, that I can move back and forth. This might be a little tricky. I have a feeling I might want to push it in more, but to be able to do this part and to check it, I've got to take it over into my window. So this is the view out my window, and here is my box, my Camera Obscura, and to be able to see, we've got to kind of get inside this camera. So let me kind of work on that here for a minute. So here I've got my camera stuck into the end of the Camera Obscura, and you can see that there's this blurry image. And now the tricky part of focusing comes in,
where I have to push this frame, and I'm gonna try to do it. I guess I should see if pulling first, because that's easier. If that's gonna make it more focused. Kind of tricky to see here. All right, so I pushed my frame farther in, and as we look into here, and our eyes adjust, or the camera adjusts, you can see that that image is getting more sharp across the street. And this is just gonna take a little bit of work to play with it here. So I pushed it a little bit farther in, and I'm not sure that that was better. One of the things that you've probably noticed is that this is an upside down image. The Camera Lucida flips things. That's the advantage of that mirror in there. I'm gonna keep working on focus. So I've pulled it back out a little bit more. This is just one of those things, and I may not get it super, super sharp. I'm gonna play with it some more and see what I can do. So one of the things I've realized was that I wasn't super careful about making sure my frame is rigid, so that paper that's in there, my screen, is not super flat. And that's gonna make it hard to focus. But I think you can still see that I've got a not too shabby image. I definitely successfully made a camera obscura, if not the most sophisticated one. So, I hope you enjoyed learning how to make a camera obscura, the pre-made, super finely measured wooden Camera Lucida. Definitely works better. I could probably, and you could probably, work harder at making something that fits better inside and kind of slides in and out. That screen that I created out of the vellum, the fact that it's wobbly, can't lay straight, is a problem. I could come back and make my interior box a little smaller so it's not such a tight fit, and make sure that it doesn't warp when I put it in there. But you get to see the basic premise and really how easy it is. I mean, a couple of cardboard boxes that fit inside each other, and a tin can, soda can, and some parchment paper or wax paper or whatever, you know, tracing paper, and you can make this work. If you're one of my students, I am really looking forward to seeing what your camera obscura looks like. And everyone on YouTube, I hope that you would support me. And you can do that by subscribing to my channel, sharing, commenting, liking, all of those things. Thanks.